Why do flervers mess up their quotations so horribly? Quantum Eraser, in his silly presentations, always gives links, but these are not accessible, so you have to type the sometimes long links by hand and then hope that you get directly to the quote that was mentioned. I selected randomly one page from one of his presentations. Let's first start with the easy one. Typing in this link, you get this website. Scrolling down, you get the mentioned quote. When you put them side by side, you notice that QE didn't use the exact quote. He didn't mutilate the meaning, but nevertheless, he changed the wording. That's a no-go in science. The link above this quote gives you more trouble. In fact, it isn't a link. It's just a mentioning of the California State University Northridge with the add-on hypothesis testing. In one search engine, this reference leads to no clear paper that could contain the quote. The only thing that I could remotely relate to QE is the mentioning of helping students with reading comprehension, a course that would be well worthwhile for QE. Another search engine doesn't give anything useful either. Then you try to type a big part of the text into a search engine, and again, no result. So you cannot check the validity of QE's quote, which makes you wonder why he added the whole California State University Northridge reference in the first place. We all know how fond QE is of quoting anything he could find that remotely supports his silly notions. But we also know that there have been several globers, like Bob the Science Guy, who have demonstrated that QE also has a habit of quoting from papers that state elsewhere the opposite of what QE meant to argue. Researching QE quotes for my latest video, I came across another quote by a guy who calls himself John Boyce Hart. He posted this quote: "The upper surface of a fluid at rest is a horizontal plane, because if a part of the surface were higher than the rest, those parts of the fluid which were under it would exert a greater pressure upon the surrounding parts than they received from them, so that motion would take place amongst the particles and continue until there were none at a higher level than the rest, that is, until the upper surface of the whole mass of fluid became a horizontal plane." From First Principles of Natural Philosophy. There is only one book with that title, from James Renwick, published in 1842. But this book doesn't contain the mentioned quote. There is, however, a book called The First Principles of Natural Philosophy by William Thynne Lynn, published in 1863. So the reference is wrong to begin with. Anyway, here you see the text as it is, but if you look at the search result, you see that the quote given by John Boyce here, Hart, is heavily edited. Someone has taken much trouble to edit out the word gravity. Who was the culprit?
First, there is our old friend William Carpenter, the snake oil peddler who published the book Theoretical Astronomy Examined and Exposed in 1866, just 3 years after the publication of Lynn's book. He quotes Lynn correctly, by the way. Soon after that, there is, for the first time, the butchered quote in the book Synthetic Cosmogony, or Conclusive Evidence that the World is Not a Rotating, Revolving Globe, but a Stationary Plane Circle, from 1899, by Thomas Winship. Winship, by the way, also names the wrong title. And then again, what a surprise, there is Eric Dubay, this certified con man who has copy-pasted most of Carpenter's work and kept all of the inaccuracies and blatant lies in it, has copy-pasted this messed up quote from Winship again, mutilated and all. Of course, giving the wrong title of the book also.
His misquote can be found both in his book The Flat Earth Conspiracy as on his website Flat Earth 101. It can also be found at the Facebook page Flat Earth Matters. And now there's John Boy's Heart, who parrots this whole nonsense all over again. This now is the general modus operandum of flurfers. They just parrot each other, repeating after each other quotes that are incorrect without checking the origin of it. And to top it off, searching for a book with the title First Principles of Natural Philosophy, at first I found the James Renwick book from 1842. But reading through it, I found some interesting observations about level and horizontal that would be common knowledge in those days. Level lines are drawn on such surfaces, and the art of leveling consists in tracing such lines either actually or by vision. We have no instruments by which lines lying in curved level surfaces can be drawn. We are therefore compelled to content ourselves with straight lines tangent to the level surface. So even in 1842, they knew that the level surface was curved and that you establish a horizontal line as a tangent to that level curved surface.
About horizontal, Renwick states this:
the direction of gravity is also said to be vertical, and any line or plane perpendicular thereto is said to be horizontal. As the figure of the Earth is nearly spherical, the several directions of gravity at different points on its surface converge, and were the Earth a perfect sphere, they would meet in its center. And again, this is from 1842.
Would that be the reason that Winship, Dubay, and all other flurfers who have used the messed up quote from Lynn carefully edited the word gravity out of it?